how to fight and beat Goliath, but he taught my fingers how to war. When I think about that, he was just a warring man, but he is a type of Jesus Christ. So every time you see David, you got to pay attention. So here David is sending his men, because he's the king, to offer condolences. I'm still in verse 3, and I'm just showing you. It says, and thinkest thou that David does honor thy father? He send these comforters unto thee? Have not David rather sent his servants unto thee to search the city and to spy it out and to overthrow it? In other words, instead of David sending them to comfort you because your daddy died, David sent him to be a spy because Israel's up to something. He's trying to overthrow you. Look at this. Oh, God, this is too rich. It shows the mercy of God for even people who don't go to church. Whole lot of folks using the word God, and God ain't even did that to you. He blessing you. The day ain't came when God damn everybody. I got to it anyway. But you will say it. You don't know God if you saying that. Because if God get the, he'll turn the world upside down, man. He's the God of all spirits. If he get the blessing, he'll make you weep and cry. He can bless your socks off you. Hallelujah. He blessed David till he came out his clothes. Yeah. Lord, bless me to dance until my shirt get wet. Yeah. When I get home, I got to wring them out. Yeah. Don't let age be nothing but a number. Don't let a doctor's report be nothing but what he's seen on the screen. But while I yet live, the dead, they praise him not. She got up and danced a little bit. And when you do it, I'm not going to laugh at you. Because you might be doing it and thinking you're playing. Shirley Caesar's got a testimony how she was playing church and fool around and got the real Holy Ghost and now rocked the whole world. So thank God for David. But look at here. You got to see this, man. Brothers, you got to see this. Look at the brothers and say, brothers, you got to see this. Verse 4. Wherefore Hanun took David's servants, took God's servant, took people who loved Jesus, and shaved off half of their beards and cut off their garments in the middle, even to their buttocks, and sent them away. Ooh, boy, I tell you what, that's just meaty to me, Lawrence and Mario. The enemy, Mondre, Dakari, what's your name, brother? Marcus, Conrad, Terrence, Brother Wayne. The enemy wants to do a couple things to you and me. Xavier, Zymir, little brother, he wants to shave off your beard, half of your beard, and uncover your behind. Because he wants to humiliate you. His greatest pleasure, brothers, is when he can humiliate a man. And there ain't no greater in this day because all men grew beards and they didn't even get them trimmed up. They just grew them. They wouldn't, you know, we go and get them, line that up, brother. Get the wild hairs. No, they grew that joker till it come down to their navel because it was part of how they live. But here, David done sent his men to offer love and kindness, and the enemy gets the suspicion and say, I'll tell you what we do. Grab them, no good suckers. Bring them in here. Let's shave off half their beard, and let's uncover their clothes to the buttocks so they can show their behind Let's insult them. That's why the Bible says about what a man needs is reverence, respect. That's why brothers will cap on you, man, in the middle of the street. If you step on their shoes, if you say something, they go to the house and get a piece and ride back and come get you, man, because it's about something we wired that you ain't going to insult me. Don't let me be with my lady, because she's going to get me home and ask me why I didn't. I'm hollering at her and didn't holler at you. So, yeah, you're going to pull your strap on me. Why didn't you pull your strap on that boy at the 7-Eleven? So, brothers know what I'm talking about. You know, that's why we respect a brother. We see him. Hey, what's up, brother? We make y'all give him like, what's up, my brother? My brother! What's up, another mother? We respect him because what we saying, you know, man, we can't handle no insults. All the brothers said amen. Can I get amen? Our brother, we can't handle it whether it come from my woman, whether it come from you, Igro. We can't handle no insults. We love Jesus, and we'll go in the closet, and we'll pray, we'll fast, we'll dance, we'll work hard, man, but we'll do anything to try to avoid that insult. And that's, you know, this ain't about pitting brothers against sisters, but the sisters in the land that know, I found out how to insult a brother. They do it first with their eyes when they look at him and look at his feet, because now you're saying, you shout. And then if you say the wrong thing out your mouth, and that's why we can't handle it, man. Can I get an amen in here, brothers? We'll go in the closet and suck our big old thumb, my God, and watch TV. Amen. We'll go kick cans, kick rocks, go pull the transmission out in the car running fine and put it back in. You know what I'm saying? We'll cut the grass, and it don't need cutting. But you know what I'm saying? Because we done been insulted. Some, hello. We, you know, we try our best. Most of us ain't, baby. Okay, honey, I understand. But a whole lot of us ain't yes men. Amen. We spend most of our life apologizing. We ain't yes men. Okay, sweetie, whatever you say, love. A whole lot of, and if you're looking for one of them, you might have to look a little harder. This ain't about that, though. Because you're going to have to learn how to not insult us. Because there's something about the fabric of a man, come on, stay with me here, that when you insult him, you have come against his, you come at him hard. And so the enemy knew how to get at brothers. He said, I'm going to shave his beard off, half his beard. It's okay if you can't grow one. But if you're trying to get them three little hairs down there and some cat come along and shave it, and then pull your pants down, you can't go to the corner, hang out high five with the homies, and this dude over there done pull your pants down. Help me. Your wife know about it? Your daughters? They looking at it. Daddy, what happened to half of your beard? And why your pants around your ankles? Because their buttocks is showing. But let's read what happened in the Bible. It says, and when the children of Ammon saw that they stank before David. Oh, God, I ain't got time. Man, I'm going to give y'all a little snack. This is a little snack. When the enemy get to messing with you, he know he stank. What we call it in the hood, that's some foul stuff. The enemy already know that when he mess with you and insult you and do anything that causes your integrity to be impugned, whether it come from friend or foe, he done some foul stuff. Oh, y'all need to stay with me. It don't matter who the devil using, whether he using the white man, God bless all the white men. He using the red man, God bless all the red men. He using another black man, that's why the penitentiaries are full. Come on, somebody. He used your daddy. You'll stand up and say, all right now. You showing them three little hairs on your chest. You'll be like, come on now here, Roscoe. Because you done insulted me. And what men are suffering from today is insult. What's wrong with the men? They insulted. It ain't the church that insults them. It's life that has insulted them. The devil in any form he could get has insulted them. Every man, male, wants dignity. Whether he only makes $10,000 a year, whether he's on a fixed income, whether he's waiting on a check once a month. My God, he's a veteran and he limp, you know, because his leg shot off. Whether he's in a wheelchair, he lives to be respected. Guys in wheelchair, where I come from, got a pistol in the seat because they're going to say, I'm in this chair, but you ain't going to respect me. You're going to disrespect me. Every man you know is living not to be insulted or respected. No kind of way. Even when he wrong. Because among men, even when you're wrong, you just say, hey, my bad, dog, my bad. This is what you say, my bad. You don't stand up over him. You ain't never going to be nothing. You ain't nothing. You're just like your daddy. Like that, man, you've been, yes, sir. You can't do it. And then you're going to take him down. That's a nice looking rag you got there, son. You're going to put him down on the floor and take that off of him? And then send him home? Expect him to walk around life with a half a beard? And these brothers, your sons, your husband maybe, your grandchildren, if they males, why you kill them when they two? You start making them feel like less than men. They walking around here from the time they go to school. Lord, come on, they insulted. They might be nice little boys like that 13-year-old yesterday, but somebody going to try to get them in the playground and insult them. You can't insult me on the basketball court because I'm going to be like Mike. I'm going to put my tongue out and I'm going to jam it, and y'all know I can't jump. That's why Michael was who he was. Can't trash talk a man. Because there's something in some of us. The trash talking is what turned the gorilla on. Can't play no football until the trash talking starts. Yes, that's the way we wire. You gonna do what? All right then, all right. Come get some of this. Yeah, what? Come get somebody. And that's in fun. But when we deal with real life, and the enemy say, I'm going to pull a stanky move on your son. I'm going to pull a stanky move on your husband. I'm going to pull a stanky move on your brother, your cousin that keeps getting in jail and crack and can't get out. You wonder, what's wrong with him? He's a fool. He has been insulted. He can't grow his beard back. He can't pull his pants back up. And yes, the church should help him, but when you see one, if you know him, you what you don't want to do is let the enemy use you to shave him again. Put no rocks in his pants, wad it down, because he's dealing with insult. Going to a store, I told anybody I got four sons. Talked to one of them this morning. We were laughing about his age, and he wasn't sure his age. And he said he just kind of figured out. He'd been telling everybody he's 47, he's 49. And I told him, well, son, you calling me to wish him happy birthday, but really, I'm your son. You my daddy. You know, we just had a little fun. But he called me, love on me. But the thing is, I tell anybody, if all four of my sons was walking down the sidewalk, and it was pitch black, if you seen them, all four of them, Chris, Wayne, Damien, Chantrell, all of them taller than me, standing so high, and they all dressed like young people dress, if they walked down the sidewalk and I didn't know them, I would go to the other side of the street. But all of them together ain't nothing but lovers, nice guys. Do you hear what I'm saying? But you take them same men, you take them into a store, and somebody insults them by looking at them and clutching their purse. Getting in the elevator and see them and then get out and say, you could, you know, life has a way of insulting them. On a job, promote somebody else over them and you can feel it's because of my color. And all of them are good guys. None of them would mug you. None of them would steal from you. For people, they have been insulted, but they're like every other, not just a black man, men, they're insulted. They're insulted so much, they can't look mama in the eye, daddy in the eye. You look at the top of the head when you talk to them most of the time. Because they're insulted. And they go to church. You ain't teaching them. We blame the church. That church ought to. And you go home, you married a professional woman, good at insulting. Your mama's still in the earth. She insults you. Robert, you just like your daddy. See, your daddy, you act just like Ronnie, Robert. Just like it. He insults. Men know it stinks. But hang on. Let me get to the ending real quick. Verse 6 here. Look at it here. Excuse me. Verse 5. He said, when they told it unto David, he sent to meet them because the men were greatly ashamed. I want you to start looking at the man in your life, and you ain't got to ask him, because we ain't going to tell you. Unless we absolutely trust you, we'll sleep with you and we'll tell you. Oh, I wish I had some male voices in here to grumble or something. Help me, man. I'm taking one for the team here. Last thing we want, our woman and our kids, and anybody know we're ashamed about something. I mean, don't get me wrong. We know how to humble. We should be learning humble. I'm ashamed. I shouldn't do that. But, you know, y'all want us to come back crying like women with the hanky. I'm so sorry. I'm so, you know, we got to work up on all that. Yeah. Thank you. I like you. Give us some time. We got to be married like 60 years so we do all that snotting. But you ought to be able to talk about everything. I don't know. Say amen, brothers. I might be ashamed about the fact that I wish we could live better. Might be ashamed about the fact that I'm getting older. I remember my dad was dying, and he worried about mama. Mama, I didn't leave mama this big old mansion to live in. I might, you know, we ain't looking for you to always get in big debt and buy a big house, so if you die, I got it. You know, we like, wait a minute. But we got ideas. Hello, can I get some brother amen? We might be ashamed that we didn't do a good job raising our kids because we were too busy trying to make money, drinking, and doing other stuff before we really turned. Come on, brothers. We ain't going to just come to you all the time. I'm so ashamed. I'm so ashamed. You know, you'll get all that out of us. Just open up, Robert. Open up. We're looking at you what you want. I'm not opening up like that. I ain't the one. You just be nice to me. Can I get an amen, brother? And then little by little, I let you into my world. But, you know, you want me to come. Honey, you know, right? I know it ain't going to happen. Who going to help us in a fight? Okay. One day, we're going to have more brothers to preach to. And they're going to help me, man. But look, come on, look at the word. He says, verse 5, when he told the David, he said to meet them, because the men were greatly ashamed, and the king said, tarry at Jericho until your beards be grown and then return. Now, here's what I want to say to brothers, that your beard may have been cut off. You may have been living, showing your behind. It's in the book. Everybody done seen your behind. You know how we say it in the hood. You out there in them streets showing your no, breaking in the stuff, you know what I'm saying? Driving drunk, you know what I'm saying? Beating on that girl. You know, you done lost your mind. You might be done that. But God ain't through with you. Let's take a praise break. Come on here. Come on. Let's take a praise break. Come on here. Come on, let's praise it. You know some man that's showing his behind right now. Might be your nephew. And everybody done labeled him. You know, that's Willina's child. You know, he just said, boy, ain't never done. But that ain't the way God deal with it. Because look, the Lord said, look what he said. He says, tarry at Jericho till your beards be grown. See, Jericho was a stopping over place to get refreshed, to get built up, to get encouraged. Come on, brothers, lift your hands. Help me out here. I'm tired of preaching to girls. Yeah, I'm tired of preaching to girls. We're going to baptize a man today. Reggie, ain't we? That's, I love that man. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands. But brothers, you got to tarry till your beards be grown. That means you might have to tell them zeros, hey, you know, I'm getting out the love business, girl. Don't call me no more. You know, I'm done with you. She done talked all crazy to you now. When you tell me I'm leaving, now she don't start tripping, you know. Oh, no, 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 you don't know. Mm-mm. Out. Yeah. But look, and then when the children of Ammon saw that they stank before the devil. Don't you know that when the enemy has got you trapped in anything, when you are defeated, he know he's stinking before God. Our problem is, minister, we get to grin with the enemy. We pray like that. Lord, I know I stink. My life stink. I'm stinking. I'm just a stinking mess. And, you know, and the Lord ain't like tripping on the stink. He like, but I got blood. I can wash it. Oh, but I'm stinky. The stuff I'm doing is foul, Lord. It's just foul. And that's our relationship with him. He already know you're stinking. We all stink without the blood. Our righteousness is nothing but filthy rag. Can you say amen? We can go to church and be stinking. We can be a preacher and be stinking. Be a choir member and be stinking. Be a deacon and be stinking. Don't stop coming to the house of the Lord. But the Lord know where you stink. And he don't want the relationship to just be built on you calling yourself stank any more than a father would want his son coming to you. But I'm such a wimp, Daddy. Daddy, I'm such a wimp. Daddy, he said, no, you can make the team, son. You can play, you can make the first squad. You can at least the second squad. Maybe they'll let you help out, son. You can do it, but I'm such a loser. Now, you may call that humility, but that father pretty soon, he going to, am I right? We got any more daddies like that? He goes, shaky boy, what's wrong with you? What was wrong with you? Daddy, I'm such a loser. Daddy, I'm a loser. You know, after a while, that ain't cute. It's your mama going, oh, my baby, come on, let mama cook you some soup, baby. We'll talk about daddy going to say, your daddy trying to train you. You ain't supposed to walk around. Don't get me wrong. Things will get you down, son. But you can't come to me. Quit acting and expecting a man to act like a woman. Because he ain't just. Now, he do daughters like they're all, come here, little puffin. Come here, dear, your daddy, your daddy. Now, who did it? Daddy go get him. But little boy, daddy ain't going to be, oh, come here, little. Now, when he little, when he get bigger, daddy going to say, well, hey, wait a minute here. I'm saved and do speak in tongues. But look, we going to Dick's. And we're going to get some boxing gloves. Yeah. We're going to get you in the karate classes. How about that, Junior? You don't keep running home to me. Are you with me? So now Jesus will do the same thing. And what has happened to a lot of men they eventually dropped out of worshiping together with others, and they drop out of marriages. And they'll love you, woman, as long as you don't find out they stanky. I thought you said you had 780 credit score. I looked at your mail, and your credit around 482. Oh, baby, no, honey. Okay, now that's the truth. That's an issue. But now you done just made yourself look like a gold digger, because I thought you said you loved me. You weren't saying that when I paid your car note. You weren't saying that, you know. My mama told me I should have married you before I moved in with you. But now and I need this and I need that. Then you done found out these stuff. I thought you said you only have 5 kids. This girl came in the beauty shop. She said she got one of your ugly kids. You just spread your seed all over the land. You didn't tell, oh, yeah, that's right. I do have one. But see, we didn't get a paternity test. And then he got to complaining all that. Oh, you just foul, Robert. You foul. You a lying. The truth ain't in you.
Because you done found one little thing about his life.
And you been to jail? You got a prison record? You didn't tell me. We all ain't been dating but a week. I Googled you on people. And you got an assault charge that you battery been in, whatever. Well, baby, somebody broke in the house, you know, and I had to hit them across the head, whatever. You was a rapist or something. You know, and am I right about it?
Oh, and when the children of Ammon saw that they stank before David. Ladies, y'all can get some of this too.